Imagine waking up one morning, making your coffee, sitting down at your computer, only to discover that your WordPress website is hacked, someone's gotten into your email, all of your social media accounts have been taken over, and nothing seems right in your world. A lot of people think this is pretty far-fetched, but if you get an info stealer on your computer, on your cell phone, you could be a victim of this type of attack. Info stealers are becoming more and more prevalent, and hackers are using info stealers to take session cookies to take over online accounts. We're going to look at some articles that tell us how prevalent this is actually becoming, and then we'll look at steps you can take in order to protect all of your online accounts. If you're new here, my name is Kathy Zant. I have been an IT professional for well over 20 years. One of the first web servers I was gifted from one of my coworkers got hacked, and so I was thrown into the midst of security education. If you're new here, like the video if you learned something new and subscribe for more content just like this. I first learned about these info stealers taking session cookies and getting into WordPress sites from my friend Thomas Raef. Thomas runs We Watch Your Website, and he not only looks at website files, he looks at log files and watches what's happening on WordPress sites. He has over 9 million sites that he's watching right now, and that's doubled from a year ago. So he has a very large sample size. Log files are access logs. These are telling you what kind of requests are coming into a website. On this blog post on his website that was published on January 3rd, 2024, he basically walks through the data that he has showing that over 850 billion log entries that WordPress websites are getting hacked at scale through authentication credential compromises, not through plugin or theme vulnerabilities. So this means either people are getting usernames and passwords and they're logging in that way, or they are getting in through session cookies. And he's got enough data here to explain what that all means. So there's basically multiple types of hacks that can happen to WordPress sites. But the big one that all of us, whether we're in WordPress or not, can learn from, stolen session cookies and authentication compromise is becoming more and more prevalent. It's particularly nasty because it bypasses all authentication protections such as multi-factor authentication, passkeys, username, password, all of the protections that you have on a WordPress site get bypassed when someone has a session cookie. Now, what is a session cookie? Let's take a look at that. All right, first of all, to understand how websites work, you have a web server that has files, a database, files that talk to a database. All of this information is stored on the web server, and your browser, whether you're using Chrome, Brave, Safari, Edge, whatever browser you're using, requests information from that server, and then it gets that information, loads it into your browser, and you interact with that particular website. In order to maintain a state, maintain a session, maintain knowledge that you are who you are, websites use what is known as session cookies. Session cookies, as it says here, are cookies that last for a session. A session starts when you launch a website or web application, and it ends when you leave that website or close the browser window. Now, here's the thing. You've probably loaded up your computer in the morning, powered everything on with your coffee, and you're logged into Facebook, you're logged into Twitter, you're logged into your email. Those session cookies are still in the browser, and those extended sessions go on for weeks, sometimes months. Those sessions continue. So if someone has access to your computer, let's say, for example, you downloaded a PDF and that has an info stealer in it, while you were sleeping the night before and left your computer on, a hacker could get into your computer, get your session cookies, and basically take over all of your accounts. They could take over your Gmail account. They could take over Facebook, Twitter, anybody that's using these persistent cookies that last for an extended period of time. They could take over your WordPress website because WordPress websites have a 48-hour cookie unless you clicked that box to remember you, in which case that cookie will last for 2 weeks. Once an attacker has that cookie, they can basically take over the site because it looks like you. It's authenticated. That cookie is all that WordPress is really looking at. So they can get into your WordPress site. They can install malware to infect other computers with info stealers. They can do all sorts of malicious redirects. WordPress is a juicy target for these types of attacks because once you have access to that WordPress website, especially if it has a ton of traffic, even if it doesn't have a ton of traffic, it's a juicy target because it can be used in command and control networks. I've seen it 1,000 times. Now, here's the thing. You've probably noticed when you've logged into your bank account's website to check on your balance, pay bills, transfer money, that it will come up with a little dialogue saying, "Are you still here?" And it's getting ready to close the session. It may have a little countdown timer. Those types of sessions don't last very long. Banks are seeing these types of attacks happening. Therefore, they are limiting the length of time that that logged in session can persist. So it can be very annoying when you're trying to do a number of different things and your bank is logging you out because you have to go look something up or you get distracted. But those bank accounts are being protected by having non-persistent cookies. Now, let's say, for example, you have a bank account that is storing a cookie that has your username in it, but it's not a session cookie. So you come to the website and your username is already there, or you've asked it to remember your username so that it's easier to log in, those types of things. That is not the same as a session cookie. A session cookie means you're logged in. Things like social media, however, things like Gmail, these are allowing you to stay logged in for extended periods of time. Now, for lots of us who are using our Google accounts to log into a number of different services, this is OAuth. Say you use Notion. Notion has single sign-on with Gmail. You can use your Gmail account to log into Notion. If an attacker is able to compromise your Gmail account, they can get into all of the other accounts that are using that single sign-on method because they can pretend to be you. Now, additional protections are in place. If you are at a cafe or if you travel and your Gmail account will ask you to authenticate to say, "Is this really you?" because you're coming from a new IP address, that type of thing. But there are plenty of other persistent session cookies that exist that maintain state and don't do those types of checks. WordPress is one of them. It is not checking your IP address. It is not checking to see if you're logging in from the same device. And attackers can take the cookie and they can basically spoof that and log in with whatever that they would like. They just form the request so that it looks like the user agent is coming from Chrome. They can do all sorts of things to spoof this. And there's even tools that allow them to do this very, very easily. Let's take a look at another article that will explain how pervasive this cookie stealing technology is becoming and why it's so important for us to protect ourselves. This article comes from cybernews.com, and this is an interview with Trevor Hilligoss. He's a former FBI digital crime expert, and he's currently the vice president of Spy Cloud Labs, and he is talking to us about these info stealers. So cookie theft isn't new, he's saying, but it is becoming more and more pervasive. So these cookies can be imported into a criminal system, spoofing your device. That's basically what we're seeing happening with WordPress. This method's on the rise since many users are now using multi-factor authentication, making it harder for attackers to access accounts with stolen passwords. So he's saying this is much bigger than just Google. Cookie theft has been pervasive for so long. Very few people really understand how serious cookie theft is and how difficult it is to prevent. So they can get into your Gmail account. If they do that with that pervasive cookie, they can reset Facebook passwords. They can get into basically everything, and you're not going to realize it until morning. Criminals are doing this every day, he states. He talks about a tool that they use called Llama that is pretty easy for these attackers to use. He's saying that the info stealer community is picking up on this. They've used cookie theft as a way to get access to accounts for a long time. So these cookies establish an expiration time for your sessions, like we just talked about, and malicious actors having access to cookies and device information no longer need to know your username or your password or your passphrases or your 2FA in order to get into your accounts. So this can happen to your bank account, but as we mentioned, banks for the most part are starting to limit the session time, so it's not as attractive to them. But if you have malware on your device and a hacker on your device at the exact same time, and you're logged into your bank account and they can get into your bank account very rapidly, they can bypass those security controls of a session timeout. So websites, as I mentioned, are starting to perform additional checks to ensure the device is the same and belongs to the same user, but these attackers are able to become you. And it's not just Gmail. It's happening with a lot of other accounts. So he talks about how do you even protect yourself from such attacks. And the first thing to do, of course, is to make sure that you don't get infected to begin with. Because this info stealer malware is extremely pervasive. We're seeing literally hundreds of thousands of unique infections every single day around the world, especially in the countries that are targeted the most, like Europe and the United States, where attackers can make a lot of money. So he's saying you should have good endpoint monitoring, installing an antivirus and keeping it updated, and very important to not click on ads. A lot of malware is spread through advertising networks, so try not to click on ads no matter where you're seeing them. Sorry, Wayfair, I'm not clicking on your ad. But clicking on ads, a lot of ad networks do have malware within them, so it's really important not to click on ads. Don't download any PDFs. Don't download anything that's coming as a phishing type of attack through your email. Revoke access to devices that you no longer use. Here he goes over how criminals are renting powerful malware for just a few $100s. Llama C2 includes the latest exploits of authentication protocol OAuth2, and they are not spending a ton of money doing this. We're not talking about things you have to code yourself. This is something they can just rent. He says he's been working info stealer malware for a long time, and he said that in the last year, in 2023, seen more new advances in info stealers than any other year previously. So I had a friend ask me, should I go into my browser and delete all of the cookies for every site that I've ever visited? No, you don't have to do that. There's one simple solution that can protect your Gmail, that can protect your Facebook, your Twitter, your bank accounts, everything. And that's to make sure you're logged out. You know, I've been in security for a long time. I love being able to just start up my computer and I'm already logged into all of my social networks. I'm logged into my email. It makes everything so much easier. But when it comes to info stealers, the best thing that any of us can do is to log out of those accounts. You don't have to go delete all of your cookies, just log out. And that destroys the session cookies. So if you are ever in a situation where you download a PDF and just take a look at it, and all of a sudden you have an info stealer, or you accidentally click on a link, or an ad accidentally, the page that you load on your browser ends up shifting and you accidentally click on something, you can protect yourself by taking that extra step of just logging out. Make sure you have antivirus on your computer. I am running antivirus. I hate having to have antivirus on my computer, but I am using Avast. Had to use it at the last job, so I've just left it there. Make sure that I have my virus definitions updated and that it's scanning frequently. And I make sure that I log out of things after I am done using them. Also really important that when you see that Chrome needs an update, that you update Chrome. Any type of software on your system needs an update, that you're updating it. When your OS, when your operating system, whether you're on Mac or Windows, needs an update, make sure you're applying that. And if your device, if your cell phone has a software update, make sure you're applying all of those patches, because there are tons of security patches. And over the past couple of years, we've seen a number of 0 days that have affected users that have been exploited in the wild, and then the patch comes out. It's important to remember that security is a continuum. The most secure computer is going to be encased in cement and buried 6 feet in the backyard, but that's not exactly usable. The most easy to use computer is the one that doesn't have any passwords or any protections on it whatsoever. For each one of your accounts, routes for each thing that you're logging into. You have to decide how important is that to you. For your bank accounts, your crypto accounts, where you keep all of your money and your assets, protect those things. For the email account that is used to authenticate to those types of things, protect that account. Make sure that you are separating things that don't matter so much versus things that are mattering a lot. And another person asked me whether or not they should use the password managers that are in browsers. I've seen enough 0 days happen with Chrome that I recommend that you use a standalone password manager and that you don't use the plugins that allow to make that easier. Again, that's that continuum, right? You want your passwords stored someplace that aren't connected to the browser, that aren't connected to all of the internet types of things. So use a password manager, keep your passwords safe there. Make sure you're protecting all of your authentication information separate from the thing that you're browsing. So I don't recommend that you store your passwords in Chrome or in a browser-based password system unless it's something that doesn't matter. My test websites, all the passwords are within the browser for those because if those get hacked, I don't really care. It doesn't impact me that much. I will just probably wipe the site and install a fresh version of WordPress, that type of thing. But if it's incredibly important to you, if it's something that you use, like Facebook, if you're using Facebook to authenticate to another service, if you're using Gmail to authenticate to another service, protect those things and fortify them. It's going to make your life harder, but a harder life is a safer life, at least with internet security. My name is Kathy Zant. If this video helped you understand cookies and info stealers and gave you some advice to help you stay safer, give me a like. Subscribe if you want more videos like this. Leave a comment if you have any questions. I'm here to answer them. And subscribe to my newsletter. KathyZant.com is where you can find that. That's the Zantastic newsletter. I write about security, but I write about a bunch of other things as well, both in the WordPress space and sort of just in making life a little bit better all the way around. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.